gold, another silver necklace, iron gauntlets, and a staff of woe. Let go of everything. Hi guys, this is Nomadic Gamer, and welcome back to another episode of Skyrim Special Edition. And we are just leaving this first outpost that we have claimed and took, and now we are heading into the very mountainous regions towards the barrows. And I fixed the controls, actually, so the left mouse button controls the sword. Bleakfall's barrel, that's what it is. I was kind of wanting to see if I could see the larger mountain to kind of like compare it. Meet them head on.
Let's see what you've got.
Hero.
Do your worst.
Gotcha. Great sword, but I think it's two-handed. Can I pick up these arrows? I can.
Make a fine rock, cat.
Oh, you would. Thanks. I actually that went very, very well. Very, very well. I think that's my health down at the bottom bar. Right, Bleak Falls Barrow. Oh, you want to know what this reminds me of? Tomb Raider. A game I have not played in ages. Bread, gold, the lockpicks. Need any of that? Wait. Oh, my carry weight. I need to see about changing. Sorry. Uh-oh. Nice. Nice, it's pretty awesome. Man, I wanted to hear what they were saying. To hear what they were saying. Whoa! That was cool. That was very, very cool. I was looking up online, like some mods that some people have like compiled together, and this doesn't go anywhere, does it? I was kind of listening back to my videos. Real quick side note, when I go to turn, you know, I have to, I'm a bit loud with the mouse when I try to turn. That's useful or not in for anything, but I was looking at like some mods that people have compiled together, and go. That should do it. And some of them that they looked at. Oh. Yeah, things like that. Pickpocket automatically leveled up. Again, it's like, it's just so much to really take in. What is it? Oh, I don't. Oh, its value is 60. Yeah, I'll just take it and sell it later on, why not? Take that. Yeah. Some of the mods that they were looking at were like extreme. Oh, hey there. I knew they were coming, I just... Did I get him? Now I did. You got 8 gold on you. Oh, I'm glad I... Yeah, I'm sorry for the sound of the mouse. It's just really difficult to turn, like, really quickly. Oh, let me get the other one. Yeah, why not? But yeah, a lot of that was like extreme survival kind of stuff. A lot of it was like extreme, like weather, extreme like survival kind of thing, and just general, like it was like extreme cold. Like if you got yourself wet, you could die. If you didn't have like the right tools, the right stuff. So. And yes, let me save this really quick. And then there were other ones that were like just little teeny tiny details. And it's kind of like, yeah, I can see how some little details would be, you know, they would make sense, like make people look better, whatever, but, or adding, I like mods that like, listen to me, I've never even dealt with mods before, but like, I like the idea of mods that add more stuff, like more quests, more land, more worlds, more general things to do. Oh, jeez. Oh, dang. Your health is low, you should drink a potion. I should, shouldn't I? Oh, I leveled up too. Let's see, potions. Ah, you can't get me in here.
Get it away from me. Get it away.
Let's see, let me. Wow, this is like really difficult. Oh, you did. Alright, well. Really quickly then. Your magic is low. Okay, clearly I need to get better all around, because there was actually... There was actually one mod that was very intriguing. Okay. I missed! How did I miss? How did I miss?
Don't leave me for Arkansas.
Ugh.
Get me out of here.
It's those bones again, I think.
Get me out of here. Get me out of here. Don't leave me for Arkansas.
One of them that I one mod that I found really, really helpful, that I thought seemed really, really cool, was the mod that lets you train. Like, it made sense. It was a mod that made sense.
Don't leave me for RK's sake.
Like, I wouldn't mind having like a little training session thing, and I could spar with a training thing and just generally get better. Okay, let's see.
You, over here.
Arval the Swift.
You did it. You killed it. Now cut me down before anything else shows up.
Where's the golden claw?
Yes, the claw. I know how it works. The claw, the markings, the door in the hall of stories. I know how they all fit together. Help me down and I'll show you. You won't believe the power the Nords have hidden there.
Fine, let me see if I can cut you down.
Sweet breath of arcade, thank you. It's coming loose. I can feel it. Why should I share the treasure with anyone?
I'm going to... There we go. And there is a golden claw. And there is his journal. Kind of wouldn't mind. Well... Yeah, I do have like 380 some. Alright, let me go back and check these areas out. Okay. Embalming tool? More linen wraps? Gem. Yep. But I knew he was going to do that. Obviously the first time I played it, I didn't know. Didn't know that he was going to do that. And then he ran. Like, let me check the map. Like, he runs like all over the place, I think. No, he doesn't go back here, but. Alright. Selenius? Yes. So, here is the Golden Claw. And... a funny, funny thing about the Golden Claw. When I reach the end. But when I was... ooh. Yes, let me save it. Yes, I really, really, the battle axe. But again, I think it's two-handed. Or maybe not. I don't, shouldn't be. I'll check. Yeah, a Nordic sword. Unless I could temper it, I don't know. The war axe. That's a lot of gold. No, oh. Don't really want to step on that thing. I did it! Awesome, too awesome. This game is pretty. Even without... Oh, where are you? See, that does sell nicely, but again, I'm ready to... oh, you, bugger. Didn't mean... oh dear. I did not mean to grab everything. Alright, the battle axe. Imperial sword. Well, this actually does better damage, so let me do that. Iron dagger. And a fine iron dagger. There we go. The iron mace. Really do. I like that a lot. The ancient Nordic arrow. Or a chalcum ingot. He had a lot of good stuff on him. Yeah. Ugh. Here we go. I don't know why I was having problems. Alright, now the soul gems, I don't know how to use them. I would like to learn. Use this. Oh, dang it. No, I didn't mean to do that. Alright. Oh, the level up. Leveling up. When your level increases, you must choose to increase your health, magic, or stamina. You can also select a new perk at this time or save it for later. Available perks are highlighted in each constellation. Alright. Magic, health, or stamina. My health seems to be okay. It's my magic that's a bit on the draining side all the time. And I can use one perk on anything that I want. One-handed. Yeah, I mostly want to focus on one-handed weapons. And lately I've been using light armor. I would like to upgrade to like medium armor. If I can. That's interesting. I never... See, that'd be really awesome to, like, know the ins and outs of this game so that I can make, like, a character that's good at persuasion or, you know, things like that. You know, that's able to use alchemy without having to look things up, you know? Illusion. Manipulating skill makes it easier to cast spells like Fear, Calm, and Invincibility. Alright. This is definitely, like, I can definitely see, like, alchemy, illusion, and conjuration, like, working together, I guess, in a way. And then you have, like, destructive and restoration magic being its own thing. Heavy armor. When was I wearing heavy armor? Let's see, the art of... Let me check what it is, what it says. You can create steel armor and weapons at forges and improve them twice as much. I really... Oop. Did not mean to do that. I like that. I might do that later. Let me see what this looks like. Cast novice level restoration spells for half the magic. I like that. And then this is the same thing. I like that. Let me check the one-handed. They do 20% more damage. Yeah, I really, really like that, but... Alright. Let me... Here. And I just did... I just did the magic anyway. Oh, I think it branches off. Destruction dual casting. Overcharges the effects into an even more powerful version. Interesting. The apprentice destruction augmented flames. Fire spells do 25% more damage. Frost spells do 25% more damage and shock. And cast apprentice level spells. Okay. Alright. Yeah, let me fix that real quick. Let's see. Yeah, it is double wielded. Yeah, destruction, there we go. Yeah, I must say, I am just... Huh, is it supposed to be rainbowy like that? Oh! Yikes! Whoa! Okay, I was wondering. Ooh, no. Yay, restoration increased. Yes, I was wondering what that was. And then when my, I guess my flames like touched it, caused everything to just flame up, which I think is really cool. Did I go backwards? No. For once, no. Yeah, for someone though that has never worked with mods, I mean, the graphics on this, I think, are really a lot better than the original PC version. Like, a lot better. And then of course, I mean, the current PC that I'm on helps a lot as well. Uh-oh. Wait. Yes. Yeah, let me drop that. Yeah, let me drop like that Imperial Shield. I only need one longbow. There you go. Oh yeah. That's interesting. You can see him down there. If it's a path, why not explore? Here we go. Oh, the steel greatsword. Maybe one of these days I might make a character that prefers using double-handed weapons. Maybe I'll make a character that's actually not a Khajiit. But yeah, to me it's like these graphics, I mean these it's just really, really nice looking to me. And I really am enjoying the heck out of playing this again. He was actually a little bit tough. A bit tough. Do that. Okay. Night Eye. Oh. Maybe I should have picked the warrior stone. Okay, the Nord sword. It's just a steel axe. Oh, you bugger. There we go. Bleak Falls Sanctum. Just making sure it wasn't like a T-junction. And see, more linen wraps. And they all weigh like... they all weigh like 3 pounds each. Oh, it's just easier just to run through. Awesome. All right. Am I in a safe place? Restoration leveled up. Oop, no, distraction. Here we go. Oh, dang. That was actually really cool. The iron door. All right. And here it is. That's the keyhole. This is a puzzle. And here is how you... this is how you figure out the answer to the puzzle. Now, for the longest time, I had no idea you could do this and just take it and do that. And the answer... looks like, I want to say, bird, moth, cocoon. I need to look at it again. Oh. No, it's the bear, the moth, and the... oh no. It's an owl. A bear, moth, and owl. Oop, sorry. There we go. That took me ages to get, but it's stupidly simple. But yes, ever since I had like somewhat gotten a better PC, it's now a crappy PC now, or I mean laptop, I mean, as they always seem to be. Wow, that is just so pretty. So pretty, pretty and mysterious. Let me save. Oh wait. Yeah, I need to level up again. Health, I guess. Health would be good. Stamina actually would be good as well. And I'm definitely going... It can be upgraded 5 times. That must be the next one, fighting stance. That'll be good. Yep. But yes, I remember when I was able to finally play this game and really play it on epic, nice graphics. Well, at the time anyway, at the time. There was like a sale for Oblivion and I was able to get that for really cheap. And then I had already had Morrowind, so yeah, that's what I wanted to do, was play Morrowind, Oblivion, and Skyrim all together. But for some reason I was having problems recording Morrowind and Oblivion. I don't know why. But yeah, I did, I played through Oblivion, and it was... that was really fun as well. But yeah, it took me a very long time to get used to how the Elder Scrolls series plays, like as an RPG, because the RPGs that I played before were all very linear based, you know? I mean, I love Final Fantasy, but with this game, it's like, it's so open world, you can just do whatever. It took me a very long time to kind of like figure it out. Oh wait, no. I wanted to go here first. Word of power learned. Force. Unrelenting force. Things are gonna happen now. Oh dear. Yes! The Dragonstone. Oh. That's like the dragon language. That's just really, really cool looking. Really, really cool. The Great Sword of Cold. Oh, can I get it? Silver necklace. Just barely. Steel mace. Actually, I think that's better than what I have. Gold. Another silver necklace. Iron gauntlet. And a staff of woe. Creatures and people up to level 4 will attack anything nearby for 60 seconds. I have never seen that before. Alright. I have no idea how I'm gonna move. It's mostly in weapons and things. Yeah, that's what I want to take and sell. I want to sell a lot of these. Yeah. We'll get rid of that. Yeah, let me get rid of the sword. I wouldn't mind selling that, selling these things, especially that. Oh my word. Now that's two-handed. Alright, what about apparel? Weight 1. Foot wraps? No. Fur boots, hide helmet. No. The hide shield. Apparently, I don't do shields. Yeah, that can go. Iron armor. Gauntlets. And the shield I'll just sell. This one I'd like to sell. Increases your magic by 30 points. Silver necklace. Ring of the Minor Squire. Increases light armor skill by 12 points. Magic regenerates 50% faster. But it's like you hardly have, like, anything, oh man. Any armor. Iron battle axe. exactly? Flowers and things. That is Bleakfall Barrow. Really cool. Really, really cool. Okay. I'm actually gonna end it there. End it here. Next episode, I'll head back to the town and return the claw, turn in the quest, sell some weapons, and maybe, if I can, like, temper some stuff, because I'd really kind of like to get into that as well. So, really awesome. I'm excited. So if you enjoyed, click that like button, subscribe for more Skyrim Special Edition, and I will see you next time. Bye.